In this video, I'm going to discuss the GATE exam syllabus for electrical engineering and also look at the subject-wise marks distribution. Hi, welcome to Vedant Education, a YouTube channel that helps you to crack technical competitive exams like GATE, ISRO, DRDO, IES for electronics communication, electrical and instrumentation engineering. So if you are new here, please consider subscribing. So let's discuss the GATE exam syllabus for electrical engineering.
So the GATE exam syllabus is divided into three sections. So first we have the aptitude, reasoning and English, and then we have the engineering mathematics, and then we have the basic subjects of electrical engineering, which is analog and digital electronics, control systems, signal systems, network analysis, electromagnetics theory, and then we have the core subjects, that is power systems, power electronics, electrical machines, and electrical and electronic measurements. So now let's look at how much weightage these sections are. So aptitude and reasoning and English will come for around 13 to 15 marks. Engineering mathematics, again, 13 to 15 marks. And then you have the basic electrical subjects, which come around for 38 to 48 marks. But this can differ every year. And then you have the core electrical subjects, which come for 28 to 32 marks. So basically, the weightage within the basic and core subjects is different, but the aptitude and engineering mathematics usually come for 15 marks every year. Let's look at what are the topics involved in GATE engineering mathematics for electrical engineering. So you have linear algebra, then you have calculus, differential equations, complex variables, probability and statistics, and then you have numerical methods. Most of these topics are similar for electronics communication and instrumentation engineering. It's very important for you to study all these topics very well, because these are very easy 15 marks, and also many of the basic and core subjects in electrical engineering are dependent on the engineering mathematics. For the syllabus of the basic and core subjects, I have put a PDF in the description below that you can download for your own reference, and check out the detailed syllabus for GATE electrical engineering. So now let's look at what is the weightage of different subjects in electrical engineering GATE exam. So this is a pie chart of subject-wise weightage of different topics that appear for GATE exam electrical engineering. So first you have the general aptitude appearing for 15 marks, and then you have engineering mathematics appearing for 12 marks, and then you have networks theory, that is the circuit analysis, appearing for 12 marks again. And then you have analog and digital electronics appearing for 12 marks. Then you have power systems, which is appearing for around 10 marks. And then you have control systems appearing for 9 marks. Signals and systems, 9 marks. And then you have electrical machines, 8 marks. Power electronics, around 7.5 marks. Electrical measurements, 4 marks. And electromagnetic theory, 3 marks. So from this, you can see that network theory and analog and digital electronics have the highest weightage in terms of marks, and then you have power systems and control systems. Electromagnetic theory is quite low, around 3 marks every year. Please note that this weightage changes every year. Some of the subjects are given more weightage in some years, and hence it's better to study all the topics equally well.
So that was the syllabus for GATE Electrical Engineering. I have put all the information on syllabus and weightage in the description below, which you can download for your own reference. If you found this video useful, please give us a thumbs up and also share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel if you want to crack technical competitive exams like GATE, ISRO, DRDO for electronics communication, electrical and instrumentation engineering. You should also subscribe if you want help with placement in core companies for these engineering streams. Thanks for watching. See you later.